Hello and welcome to Rally Report tonight. After the end of the third day of the Lombard RAC, the three-hour-long convoy of cars is making its way slowly back into Carlisle tonight after a day of real drama. Kankanen had brake failure in Kielder, and Carlos Sainz is the new overnight leader. Ari Vatanen survived a monumental role to remain on the leaderboard, and Michael Moosen has made a tremendous charge to grab the number 10 spot. But sadly, Colin McRae's superb drive came to an end just a few hours ago when, in the darkness of Kielder, his Cosworth ran into the back of the stationary Cosworth of Italian Franco Cunico. Alan Douglas takes up the stories of the day.
Grizzly Grisdale has a special place in rallying folklore, and this year was no exception. It didn't affect Kankanen's leadership, but many crews emerged the worse for wear and decidedly battered. Carlos Sainz held on behind the Finn, never more than a few seconds slower, and having a sensational drive. A puncture 6 miles from the end of the second 15-mile-long Grisdale stage almost cost Kenneth Eriksson third place. That puncture and a powerful performance by Pentti Arikola, inspired by fastest time on Grisdale 1, reduced his advantage from 47 seconds to just 7 seconds. Teammate Ari Vatanen had been going well until this seemingly innocent left-hander. He hit a roadside tree stump, spilled the car and its contents onto a bank, and sent spectators scrambling. Mitsubishi management called it a quick roll. Vatanen was back on his wheels and, with his enthusiasm, if not his car, intact, was on his way again. Spectators recovered maps and service documents and delivered them to him at Carlisle. Jimmy McRae felt he was driving at 11 tenths and didn't want to go any faster. He almost didn't go any further, hitting the same log as Vatanen, but without the same results. And in the cockpit of the Toyota GT4, the same log caused more than a little upset for David Llewellyn and Phil Short. That impact caused driveshaft damage. What had been high hopes were at an end. Malcolm Wilson had been top British driver, but even on home ground was overtaken by Gwyndaf Evans. A pair of Sierra Cosworths, Colin McRae's now in a group of five home-based drivers just outside the top 10, and Franco Cunico's were only seconds apart. They were about to come even closer. It was in the Kielder complex that things really started to hot up. Kankanen had brake trouble and alternator problems, and he was about to lose the lead. But as ever, he was ice cool in spite of other hold-ups.
There's a mechanical problem on stage, and we'll be delayed for hopefully just a few minutes.
How much?
Just a few minutes, hopefully. Yeah. We'll get started as soon as possible.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Problems aplenty, but Sainz was happy moving up to top spot with Arikola 1.5 minutes behind. Kankanen had slipped to third. Then drama in the Brumilin stage. Cunico crashed, and as he tried to restart with the help of spectators, there was a collision with Colin McRae's car. As a result, both Cosworths retired. Kielder had lived up to its reputation.
So, with 34 of the total of 55 special stages completed, here's the leaderboard tonight. Carlos Sainz, the Spanish matador, who's gone like a bat out of hell all day, now sitting at number one. Pentti Arikola in the Mitsubishi has squeezed into the number two spot ahead of Kankanen. Then it goes Toyota, Mazda, Mazda, Mitsubishi, with Per Eklund in the Lancia Integrale, perhaps biding his time, but now 8 minutes adrift. So the rally is really poised for a superb challenge tomorrow as Kankanen fights to make up the 2 minutes he's lost. Now, Tony Mason spoke to the new leader as the weary crews emerged from the Kielder Forest.
How was Kielder?
Kielder was very slippery also. Very fast, very nice forest.
So you've enjoyed it?
Yes.
And what about Juha?
Juha has a problem in one stage and lose time. He lost, I don't know how much, but quite a lot.
Good. Anyway, congratulations. You're in the lead now, so you'll...
Thank you. Oh, no. Still 2 days. Very, very long rally.
2 more days, yeah. OK, thank you very much, Colin.
In Clydesdale, I cut one 90-degree left-hand corner. There was a tree stump hidden in the grass, and it just launched me over immediately.
But, I mean, it was a dramatic turnover. How much did you lose there?
Well, then we had to do another 30 kilometers, the car like that, so altogether we lost about a minute, and what I lost the confidence of my bride.
We've had a terrific run through there. I think we've probably pulled now, hopefully, around 20-odd seconds out on Jimmy in there. And we pulled quite a lot of time out of Gwyndaf, because obviously before we went into there, they got really close to us. We didn't have a very good time in Grisdale this morning. So it's nice to sort of get through Kiel. I mean, it was in good shape, and as I say, we've had a trouble-free run through it. So we've increased our lead. I think we've moved up to 10th now.
So that's it for this evening. After the longest and toughest day of the rally, 65 cars, over a third of the total, have now fallen by the wayside. Tomorrow, the cars run up into southern Scotland, then back down through Kielder before they come to a well-earned rest in that Paris of the North, Newcastle. We'll be back tomorrow at 7:40 p.m. on BBC Two and again at midnight for the night hours. But let's leave you tonight with Pentti Ericola. No, with David Llewellyn, in fact. David Llewellyn on what proved to be his last stage of this rally.
Medium left. Opens down to open 90 left. Still going. Sharp right. Fast left to long 90 left at junction. Okay, on here. Fast right tightens to medium right and sharp left. Medium right tightens and opens. Sharp right. Sharp right again. Continues. Sharp left tightens. Long sharp right tightens. There's the tightens. Sharp left. Medium left into sharp right. Tricky section here, mainly sharp bends. Caution locks. Medium left. Sharp right. Into sharp left. Medium left, continues and opens to 90 left, open 90 left. It keeps on going round to the left, like about this. Still going. To 90 right, hole inside, and 90 left. Get to the end of third Grisdale stage 27. We've damaged left front suspension.